I ask that as I retell my story. You don't judge me too harshly. I swear, I never meant to hurt anybody. It all started a couple months back. I'd been working late trying to finish my newest novel. It was around 11 p.m. when I got the first call.
Hello?
Sorry. I'm just so nervous.
Who are you?
It's one of your fans, Henry. I just wanted to call you, ask you a few questions, maybe tell a few stories.
What type of stories?
You know, scary kind. The kind you write about in all your books. Kidnapping, rape, murder.
Who is this?
I really want to meet you. You really have so much to talk about. You have to understand that I'm a big fan of yours. I really admire your work.
Are you a writer?
No. But you could say my nightmares are just like yours. Only mine are a little more realistic.
Is this some kind of joke?
Don't worry, we'll see each other soon. I'm watching.
The man behind the voice haunted me for days, and would haunt me for months to come. From that point on, I became the shattered shell of a once independent man. No matter what I did, I couldn't stop thinking about the call. It wasn't until months later, when my nightmare soon became my own reality. I started to see things that weren't there. The thought of being watched kept me up all hours of the night. I slowly began to lose my grip on reality, driving myself to a point where I questioned whether or not I was still the same man I once knew. The only thing that kept my mind off the man behind the voice was walking, walking, walking for miles. It didn't matter where I went either. I just needed to keep moving. My crumbling sanity was falling apart in my hands, and walking seemed to keep it together just a little longer. I can't express why I felt this way, but moving and never staying in the same place made me feel safe. I don't know. Maybe walking endlessly made me feel like the eyes weren't watching me. But no matter how far away you run from your problems, they always seem to catch up to you eventually.
Thanks, man. I didn't think it could rain in Arizona.
Where to?
Just a couple miles up the road, if you don't mind.
No problem.
So where are you from? What's your name, by the way?
Serious.
I'm Henry Miller. What's your name?
Bruno.
You know what? You can just drop me off up ahead. I can walk the rest of the way.
Don't be stupid. It's raining. Besides, I don't know what evil lurks around these parts.
I know you. You're the one who's been calling me. Let me out, and I'll be no trouble.
Yeah. Yeah, Henry Miller. You're the guy that writes those scary stories. My favorite kind. You want to hear my scary story? It starts with a guy.
When we imagine ourselves as characters in a book, we always believe that we would be the hero, never the villain. But that's just what I had become. A killer.
Thank you. Esta es RadioTierraCaliente.com.
And welcome back. This is KZ101.1 at the midnight hour. And you guys know what time it is? Because I do. It's
clock. Let's listen back
to some of our greatest pranks of all time. A couple months ago, we called up a famous horror fiction writer, and we convinced him that we were a
epic killer. Let's look.
Are you a writer?
No. But you could say my nightmares are just like yours. Only mine are a little more realistic.
Oh my god. Can you actually believe this guy fell for it? How come I have no idea how he didn't realize that we are actually just pranking him super hardcore. I mean, can you imagine if he went into this like crazy spiral of insanity and actually went out and killed someone on accident? A guy who was innocent?